Good morning and welcome to Reading Rec Live, week two of Summer at the Playgrounds. I'm happy to say that I have a great program in store for you for the next 30 minutes with the counselors and kids from the Pendora Park Art Camp. I'd like to take a minute to introduce my guests. To my left is Miss Tia. This is Tia's third year at Art Camp?
Yes.
Third year at Art Camp. And next to Tia, we have Michael. He's just joining us for his first year. And I'll let the kids introduce themselves.
I am Isabel Feliciano. I will be going to ninth grade. I don't know what to say.
That's it. That's all you have to say. Next.
I'm Melanie Fragoso. I am going to eighth grade.
Okay.
I am Gabby Sawyer, and I'm going to fourth grade.
All right. So thank you for coming on with me today. They have prepared with tons of artwork and prepared to give everybody all the art camp knowledge you would ever want to know, what their day consists of and all the great projects we have planned. The most exciting project, I think, would be what's currently going on, and that is the mural at the Double Tree Hotel. Tia has really taken the reins on this project, and I am going to let her talk about muraling from step one to the end. We did bring some photos that we can show you of what it takes to put a mural into effect. Want to just thanks to the DoubleTree staff again for this opportunity. They have treated our kids very well with tons of cookies. And Tia, do you want to just kind of go through this slide and talk about the mural?
Yeah. So this picture here, we are projecting the image of the mural onto the wall, and our students are tracing the image onto the wall.
And how did you make the image?
I made the image in Photoshop.
Okay.
And then I added a filter to kind of simplify the image so that we could paint it. And then that's the finished drawing of the mural on the wall. And then the next thing that we did is we pre-mixed paint to go in each portion of the drawing or of the mural. So we kind of did a paint by number thing, and the students were able to paint the colors in the areas that they were supposed to go. So they did a good job with that. And then we've been rotating through everyone at Art Camp so that they all have a chance to work on the mural. So there's after the first day, we traced it and finished painting the sky. So the kids are really excited to be able to paint on a wall.
and not be in trouble for it.
Yeah. So they're all wondering what day they were going. So we're almost finished with it. We just had to add a few top coats of paint and a few finishing touches. This is the last group that we went with. We're going again today.
Okay.
All right.
Should we show? Yeah, we'll show the other pictures later. Yeah. So overall, this has been, almost a two-week process.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I'm curious, what did you guys all had an opportunity to help with this. Is this the first time you ever did a mural?
No. For me, it is.
No? You've done one before?
Yes.
Okay. At school?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. All right. So you guys thought this was pretty cool to paint on a wall and not get in trouble?
Yeah.
Okay, so if we asked you to do a mural again, you'd be able to do it from start to finish?
Yes.
Okay, awesome. So that's one other way to start off an art camp, but with an opportunity to, leave your mark at a great hotel in Reading. So thanks again to the DoubleTree staff for allowing us to do this, and we are looking forward to many more partnerships and projects with them in the near future. So Art Camp came about two summers ago. We're now in our third summer of this art intense camp. We are trying to accommodate kids that just aren't ready to join the workforce. So Art Camp does go up to age 14. So I know Isabel and Melanie have both been there for 3 years. They're three-year veterans of art camp. So I'm just curious, Isabel, what have you learned? What are you most looking forward to? Or do you see a career in the future in the art fields? Or is this really just a hobby?
It's more than a hobby, to be honest. I've like always wanted to join an art camp before because I think it's cool overall. Okay. So that we get to be at art camp and then we have like little kids coming in and like they could maybe go into art career. And I want to be like a counselor, one of those helpful ones, maybe in the future. Okay. I don't know for sure. But I think it's really cool that we get to do this.
Okay.
As a Lincoln.
So when you arrive at camp, what's the first thing you do every day?
Usually when we arrive, we could be like our parents or whatnot, and we sign in, and usually we eat lunch. And then after that, maybe we'll go outside or finish up our sketchbook assignments. And we do that every day. It's a new thing this year, but I think it's pretty nice that we get to do that.
You guys made sketchbooks this year?
Yes.
Did you bring them with you?
Yeah.
Okay. You want to show some of your sketchbook work? And who gives you your assignments? Is that Miss Tiff?
Yeah.
Okay. So do you want to show some of your sketchbook works?
Okay.
Just pick a few. You don't have to show a lot, but.
Our first one we did, like a.
Hold it up to the camera.
The first one we did was like an emoji. Collage type of deal.
Very cool.
We just had to make a whole bunch of them and make designs out of it.
Okay.
And our second one, we had to do like our shading. And I think it was pretty cool. A lot of little kids didn't really get it.
Right.
But I think it was pretty good practice.
Okay.
For our third one, we had to pick 5 different animals to choose from, and it could be like realistically or cartoony, so I just did a mixture of both. Or this page we did our self-portraits. I'm not really good at that, so I just did cartoony.
it's good.
For this one, we did our hand, and we had to do a Zentangle with it. And our last one we did yesterday was we had to draw a friend of ours.
Very nice.
Thank you.
Good job. Good job. I did see your self-portrait you were working on the other day, and it was really awesome. So
Thank you. Give
yourself a little more credit. People and hands are very hard to draw. Melody, do you want to share any of your work?
As Isabel said, for the first day, emoji collage. Try to think outside of the box, thinking instead of filling the whole page, all the emojis collide together. I just thought maybe I can add more stuff.
Very nice. It's nice to put social media emojis on paper and not have kids connected to their phones. I like that.
Same thing with the value. Little kids don't really understand it, but it's good practice as well.
Okay.
5 different animals.
Nice.
Mostly I like to draw realistically,
then
cartoony, but I do also. And I did myself a self-portrait.
Very nice.
And the hand with the Zentangles, I didn't get to do my friend yet.
Okay. All right. Wow, that looks really good. Gabby, I know you don't have your sketchbook with you, but do you want to show some of the artwork that you brought and explain what it is?
We made like a picture, and it was with water paint, and we could do any sea animal, but I picked jellyfish because they're pretty neat and I like them.
Okay, very cool. And what's your other one?
Our other one, we had to make an animal, and I chose an owl because I think they're pretty cool, and that's my owl.
Very nice. So there you have some examples of just some of the things that the kids are working on each day. I failed to mention, I want to thank Berks Arts Council for the grant that we've received now 2 years in a row that has helped us buy supplies and give the kids some art-related experiences through field trips. So we want to thank them very much for their support. Tia, do you want to talk about some of the trips that the kids are going to do this year in art camp?
Sure. The first trip that we were doing is taking the kids every other day to work on the mural. And the next trip that we're going to the Dutch Apple Theater to see a Mary Poppins performance. So we're really excited about that. And then we do two pool trips, so the kids also like going outside and playing in the pool, right, as well as doing art. And then what else are we doing? Oh, yes. Okay. So this year we're partnering with a teacher at the Reading Intermediate High School, and we are going to do a clay workshop. So we are going to work with the clay at Pendora Park, and then we are going to take a field trip to the Reading Intermediate High School for a glaze day. So that'll be really awesome to take the kids there.
Okay. So, you know, Pendora is an extension of our regular playground program, but like I mentioned, it is more art intense. And I'm happy to say that the staff this year have quite a background in all sorts of arts. Michael hasn't said anything yet, but Michael is new to our program this summer. And Michael has an extensive theater background. So do you want to talk a little bit about your experience with joining the staff and, you know, what just...
Yeah. Well, fun story. I joined on my birthday, which was pretty great.
Yes, he did.
It's a nice birthday present. but it was really cool kind of going up to Pendora Park because I haven't been there before. And just getting to meet everybody here has been honestly amazing, and it's just been a super cool experience personally and professionally as a job, because it's definitely new to me. And yeah, everybody's just super cool and kind, and the kids are great, so yeah.
So we have two art teachers on staff. We have Michael, who is in college and has a theater background, and we have another staff member who has a degree in fashion design. So I think the art camp staff should write a play.
Oh, goodness.
We can write a play. We have set designers. We have costume designers. And then the kids, obviously, would be the actors and actresses. So I think you should jam that into your schedule yet, too, Ms. Tia, because they have so much going on. The field house is set up like a classroom. We do have more pictures that we can show you of some of the things that the kids have made in a much larger scale that are hanging on the field house walls. It looks amazing. It's just an amazing place to be. And I'm sure these kids can vouch for that, but we'll go through. Whoops, of course, here I am hitting the wrong buttons. So Tia, do you wanna just talk about some of the other things that are in here?
So some of the pictures that are here, what Gabby had shown you earlier, we did animal paintings, so some of those are pictured there, and those turned out pretty neat. We got to use neon paint with those, so the kids had fun with that. This is a tree that we have, and everyone is tracing their hand and creating designs, and we're not all finished with it yet, but hopefully we will be. We might even add some feet to the tree, just to make it a little bit more full. So those are a few of the hands that are there. These are tapestries that that Miss Tiff did with the kids that turned out really awesome. They used the paint, and they worked in partners, so they did patterns on the tapestries. And then once the paint was dry, they added tassels to the top and the bottom, and they are hanging all over the rec center. So they look pretty neat, and they add a lot of color to the room. So there's another picture of those. I think that's it for those pictures.
So a couple other things that have been going on. As I said, regular playground program, this is more art intense, but they're still doing the same activities. They're still doing the tennis. They're still doing the nutrition education and stuff, which I'm curious to get some feedback. Were you guys there this week when Miss Emily came to do the nutrition workshop? Yes. So do you ever want to drink soda again?
No.
Be honest. Gabby, I know you told your mom something about this. What did you learn at that nutrition lesson week one?
I learned that not everything that you eat is so healthy for you.
Right.
So I want to start eating healthier so then I don't eat so much.
Okay. And what about soda? Were you surprised to see how much sugar is in all that soda?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's crazy. Girls, do you have any feedback on the nutrition? This is new. You guys have never done this. What did you think?
It was pretty okay, really. I liked it, though, because like there was a lot of little kids, not saying in the Pendora Park,
right.
But there's a lot of little kids drinking all this stuff, and it's really bad for you. But I think learning about it and kind of making it fun makes them want to
absolutely
a big impact on them to drink more water and be healthy.
Good. Mm, there's plenty more lessons to come, but Emily is on board with us this summer, and she had her first week of delivering nutrition education on the parks, and the feedback has been pretty funny, actually, some of the things that these kids just failed to realize, and bringing it to their attention now has it's been positive. So looking forward to the rest of her curriculum this summer. Just a few other general announcements. Next week on the parks is Retro Week. If you are watching and your kids are participating in the Summer Playground program, check out your calendar, because next week we have some really fun things going on. We're going to be doing some tie-dye lessons, wacky hair day, crazy sock day, twin day. So next week is just a fun week to get the kids involved, get them just doing, participating in crazy fun things. I know Pendora is going to be doing their t-shirts and tie-dyeing and making a big mess, because, you know, that's what you do when you're into art. So next week is Retro Week. Looking forward to seeing what the crazy things the kids come up with, because every year there's just always one that just outdoes themselves. So it's very fun. We are closed on Monday, July 4th for the Independence Day holiday, but I will say that Schlegel Park Pool is open, and as always, they do special activities for families on 4th of July. So if you're looking for something to do and you're not being invited to a cookout or having a cookout, head out to Schlegel Park Pool on 4th of July. They do games for the kids and just have activities to do throughout the day to celebrate the holiday. It's not too late to register your child for swimming lessons. There are 3 sessions this summer. I know session 1 did begin this week, but it is not too late to get your kids out swimming in the morning and learn the skills that they need. So please, any information that you are receiving through this TV show, call the main office if you have any questions. Playground registrations have closed. I'm happy to say our locations this summer are full. We've got all of our activities going. The parks, some of the parks did go on their first field trip this week to see Finding Dory. We have several parks going today as well. So things are up and running, and things are just off to a really great start. So it's hard to believe that we are at the end of week 2 already. It just flies. I know Tia brought some other artwork that we can share with everybody if you want to go through these other things from the other campers. I wish we could have brought them all, but 28 people are not going to fit in this studio very comfortably.
All right, so these are some of the animal paintings that our students did. And then I know that...
Oh, I like the neon paint.
Melanie and Isabel brought theirs as well. Yes, the neon paint was fun.
I like that one. Oh, it's really neat.
Here's the panda that was pictured before. So we definitely have a very creative bunch.
Absolutely.
This year.
Oh.
This one's cute. This is a normal. And then this one's a little more realistic. It's a bunny. And then Isabel and Melanie brought their animal paintings in.
Very nice.
So, Melanie's is still in progress, but they're definitely, they look awesome.
That looks really cool. Oh, you girls are doing a great job.
And then this week is Ocean Week. So we did sea creatures, which Gabby showed you hers earlier. These are some other watercolor paintings. On top of the watercolor, we use salt to add some texture and kind of get the ocean feel. So they did a really great job. They had a lot of fun with it yesterday.
Very nice.
So, wow. Art Camp, they're busy all day, every day. It's a great place to visit. I love to see these kids. They are super, super creative, and I really need to commend the staff on the great job that they do. So thank you, Tia. Thank you, Michael. Thank you, Tiff and Catherine. You guys are off to an amazing summer, as always. Art Camp is so much fun. I think you guys will all agree,
yes.
Right?
Yes.
Awesome. Parents, keep in mind, next summer, you know, registration generally opens the end of March, early April, that registering your children. We had to turn a lot of people away this year because registration got full. You know, the earlier the better. We do our best to get the information out there so that we can get everybody registered for a smooth transition to the beginning. So just keep in mind for next year, if you have a very artsy child, this is definitely a great 8-week program for them to spend with us. We have just a few seconds left. Do you guys want to say hi to anybody? This is your opportunity to be famous. Gabby, you want to say anything?
Hi, Mommy. Hi, Dad.
Okay. Girls, anything you want to say before we leave the program? As my 3-year veterans who were grooming to become staff in the near future, is there anything you want to say yet today? What are you looking forward to yet this summer?
More like different projects we're going to be doing.
Ceramics, are you looking forward to that one?
Yes, definitely.
Great.
Yes, I think I'm happy I get to see my old art teacher.
Oh, again. Yes. Thank you again for that opportunity that Tia arranged. Melanie, anything else you want to say?
Well, I'm glad about the ceramics too. I get to see the teacher I might be going to see when I go. And I'm glad because I'm hoping that we can learn new art skills and stuff.
Awesome. All right. Well, it's time to say goodbye. Thank you so much for joining us, and we'll see you next week with week 3. Have a great weekend.